God, being his first day of his college and wanting to major in philosophy, eagerly he rushed his way towards his class in this well-renowned university.
Welcome, Professor. If you haven't heard about him, he's one of the top leading men in his field. And he means pure business. A strong atheist is what he calls himself. Do you think this boy can change him?
Oh, I hope so. This is going to be great.
Professor Ross is coming. Professor Ross,
good morning. Welcome to Philosophy 101. Let's not waste time in any introductions and see how you fare well to my question. Which is superior, the mind or God?
Class watches in confusion, knowing how the professor is.
To make it simpler, one of these don't exist.
I think his mind doesn't exist.
I want you to write your answer on these sheets of paper.
While all the students begin to scribble with their heads bowed down, the professor spots one of the students with his head held up. Looking towards him, he asks,
"Are you done writing?"
Yes, sir.
Student walks forward and hands the sheet to the professor.
"Is this your final answer?"
"Yes, sir. Why would I write it before that?"
"You sure you don't want to change it?"
"No, sir, I would not like to change it."
"So why have you written this?"
Because I believe in it. I believe that there's a God. So, yeah.
Okay. So, have you seen God?
Have you? I don't think so. I have not seen God.
Have you touched God?
How can you touch God? I haven't touched God.
Have you felt God?
No, not that way.
Well, according to science and its three simple rules, which proves that anything that cannot be touched, seen or felt does not exist. So, God does not exist.
Okay, sir, I hear you and I get your point that something that cannot be touched, felt or seen doesn't exist. But I would just like to ask a small question, sir, with your permission.
Go ahead.
Class, have any of you seen our great professor's brains? Have any of you touched his brain? Have you even touched the professor? Have you felt his brain anytime? Sir, no offense, but according to the statement that you just made, then your brain also doesn't exist, no?
Professor gets irritated and yells at him.
"Get out!"
I don't have a sense of humor.
When they are angry or even upset, you never know how the other person feels. You may feel good that you let your frustration out, but what about the opposite person? Do you think he or she deserves that? Imagine if God was so harsh and mean to us, how would we feel? Patience is something which is very hard to learn. We must pray that our tongue be tamed and not hurt our loved ones or even anyone for that matter.
And patience too.
Chandra, what was that in class?
Exactly, no one has ever spoken to the professor like that, but my friend.
What you guys are talking about, don't encourage me. What I did was actually not right. And I kind of feel bad if I think about the professor right now. And honestly speaking, I think I should go back and apologize. What do you guys?
But why?
But as he tries to explain, he sees one of his classmates sitting by herself. He notices this one girl who seemed quite disturbed and kept herself from laughter even in the class, but instead was pondering upon something. Distracted by this, he turns to one of his classmates.
"By the way guys, who's that girl sitting over there? I saw her in her class also and even then she was sitting all by herself. She doesn't have any friends or something. What is her deal with her?"
"I think she's sad. Why, what's the matter?"
Who? Where is she? Who are you looking at?
I think she is a relative of Professor Ross, that's why she's so sad. But I think we should like go back, we should go and I think find out what's the deal with her. After all, she's our classmate. Let's go and find out what's the deal with her. Hey, good morning. I am Chandler. This is my friend Rachel, and that's Phoebe. And we were just talking about you over there. And we saw you were sitting very sad and all by yourself. Obviously, this is all of our first days in college. So don't you have any friends?
You don't know the better
box
to do than talk about me.
That is okay, but we don't like people sad around us. That is only supposed to happen when class is on. So outside class, why are you still sad outside? What is the, is everything okay?
I don't know you guys, so just leave me alone. I don't want to talk about it. So if you can just go, continue, do whatever you're doing.
Okay, maybe you can start by sharing your name, because it's my experience that if you share your problems with people you can crush.